we don't have a quorum yet, but last time we didn't have a quorum either, so I couldn't get an amendment approved. So hopefully, one more person comes, we'll have a quorum. I'll hold off with that, hopefully, because we have to get the March minutes approved and the April, because Township is talking about some of the rules. I can't give it to them, but I'm going to call the meeting to order. Welcome our ex-Biddle police person, John Flanders. Good to have you here. And I will hold off. We are going to be losing Harry and Shaw, who is with us. And as always, these junior commissioners have always been excellent. He's been a good guy. He has been a wonderful help to me. By the way, he is on your committee with me. Okay, I'm going to introduce to you our presenter, my colleague. I will have him first on the agenda, but you have to say. I'm happy to introduce to you Kara Kenyon. Kara has been appointed, well, actually she's a professional trainer, but she has been appointed Harold has been appointed by the Township of Sustainable Coordinator, and we were awarded a technical assistant grant from Sustainable Jersey to develop a local health assessment. And I have her resume, which is 4 pages, so I'm not going to read 4 pages. But she's a professional planner. She was a principal planner for the Somerset County Planning Division. She was an assistant watershed protection specialist. She has excellent credentials. She has done a lot of planning. She has done some writing, I see, excellent. She is a graduate of Rutgers University. She has a BS in environmental planning. And she also has a certificate with the Edmund J. Browski Social Plan. She has a lot of honors. I'm going to pass this around so you can read. I'm not going to read it. But it is my pleasure. Oh. And then I was appointed to a steering committee, which I attended one meeting on behalf of the HRC. And then Arian also was appointed, but since he's leaving, I may appoint an interim committee, which is good. I'll talk to you about it, okay? This is the other high school student who we have, one more year. They're going to be a... Next year, you're going to be a junior?
No, senior.
Okay.
Senior.
You're going to be a senior?
Yeah.
You're senior next year?
No, I'm junior.
Okay.
Well,
we haven't seen her because we've been on Zoom up to now.
Yeah, we've been on Zoom.
So that's why.
Do I know who you are?
Yes,
I mean,
Alina
I'm sorry, Danny, I forgot.
Okay. Say again?
I am the sustainability coordinator for the
county. Okay. Make your presentation.
Sure. Oh, okay, good.
Go ahead.
Yeah, so I'm Tara. I am, besides being the sustainability coordinator, I'm basically the open space consultant for the township. So I do staff work for the open space committee, the ag committee, the trails advisory committee, and the environmental commission. So as part of my job doing
what was the cause of it, you know, in Woodbridge?
In Woodbridge, I think the main cause was that there was just an area that was not, you know, there's an area of Woodbridge, I guess, that had a lot more resources, had a lot more access to open space. And then there was an area of town where basically all of like the warehouses were being built and there was like no major walking areas. It was along the main roadway, so that caused a lot of problems. So I did this presentation originally for the steering committee, so this was kind of telling them what their role is, but again, you all know, and Gary will keep you posted about what happens in the steering committee. And anyone, if anyone wants to get a steering committee, you know, we'll welcome anyone, of course. We love feedback. This is the project timeline. It's very loose right now, but we are, you know, we met in May, we are doing the assessment phase, so right now we're on target. It could go off target. It's okay if it goes off target a little bit because we have 15 months to do it, and my major concern is if we have to push back doing the actual assessment by a month or two to get in more in-person meetings or meet with more groups, we'd rather do that. We'd rather really, really do that. So that would be there.
Is it outreach methods?
Yes, we're going to be using. So Sustainable Journeys provided us, like, example focus group, like ways to hold focus groups. We have a survey.
We're going to use an analyzer data. What are data for you?
To collect the data, you mean?
Yeah, to analyze.
I don't know yet. I'm not 100% sure. Yeah, we haven't got that. Right now, it's just going to be basically us looking at it, but that is a really good point. I need to talk to Zach about that. I don't know what that is going to be. Yeah. We should.
How many people do you want to reach? How many, statistically, like in Woodbridge, how many people did they reach for their survey?
In Woodbridge, I don't think they reach as many people as we would like to, because I don't know that they had enough time to go out and meet all the groups. We want to meet as many people as possible. So if Safi can only go to one, if members of the steering can only go to one, me, if both, we want to go to as many as possible. So I mean, honestly, if I could get 100% feedback, that's what I would love to get. I know that's not going to happen, but we are willing to do like the legwork and go where we have to go.
Can you put the survey online so that people can go online and fill up? That would be facilitate the
amount
of participation.
So we've given the survey to IT, and they have to turn it into like a fillable document, which they're working on right now. So as soon as that is done, it'll be on our website. There will be a posting on Facebook for it. So yeah, we'll have that come back to us.
So they can probably email it to everybody in the
township. Absolutely, yeah, and we for sure will do that.
Another good spot is like going to the bookstores.
Yes.
And then
yes.
Back to school nights, there's all the parents will be there.
Very true, yeah. And Safi had brought up like the camps, like maybe going to one of the camps one day. Like, but yeah, that's a really
back
good point.
Back to school nights are really huge because a lot of the parents show up for that. And,
yeah,
you know, all the bookstores are really good places to go to because you get good community demographics at the bookstores.
Yeah, okay, thank you.
Would you have to meet last Saturday, to go?
Oh.
There's nobody, and for me, it was a neighborhood except for me.
Okay.
I'm the only person that knows the community clean, clear through. I'm the clean activist.
Got it. Okay.
But Kathy Sackey out of Hope, she's at Hope. That's the community activist agency on the corner of North Dome, where you have Hope shit, right?
Yep.
Kathy had Sackey, the people, Mr. Sackey, part of your whole unit, because he has the garden now.
Okay.
She's in charge of the garden right now.
Awesome. Okay, I will definitely reach out to her.
Maybe you can have her send an email also.
Okay. I don't need to be on that here, please, but do it, Harry.
You want to.
Yeah, if you would like to be, that'd be great.
If you want to.
We're also having a, if you want to.
Yeah.
On Tuesday, August 2nd.
Tuesday, August 2nd. What is it, a?
Personal layout.
Oh, right, okay. I can maybe get one of us there, okay? National layout. Okay, perfect. If you want to be on there, that would be great, you know?
Do you have her email? Do you have her email?
Who, Kathy?
Yeah.
Kathy?
Yeah. If not, you can send it to me, and I'll send it to Sarah.
All right, perfect. Yeah.
I'll start with this. From what you're saying, it seems like sustainable journey, not just community, but just kind of based on what they did in Woodbridge or other places, has the local health assessment actually caused a major change in long-term policy, like zoning?
I mean, this is a relatively new action item, so I don't think any action change has happened yet. Just like the plan, the most recent plan of Woodbridge just got written. But I think for our plan, we want to have goals that are very easily implemented early on, and then also some midterm goals and some long-term goals. So our plan will definitely get like some of the ball rolling. You know, we've already done some work here in terms, we've done a lot of work here in terms of sustainability, but, you know, so yes, there's no like measurements. I can give her metrics just yet, but I'm sure there will be.
You're not out of Rutgers, though.
I'm not out of Rutgers.
You're not in Somerset County.
No, well, I'm a consultant, so I work for the township. Yeah, yeah.
You work for the town, Franklin Township?
I work for Franklin Township as a consultant, yeah.
Oh, okay.
I used to work at Somerset County.
You don't know Councilman Tate, or none of that?
Oh, no, I do, yeah.
You know Tate?
Yeah.
He was the one that got us all set up in the garden, him and John Hopper.
He would be very good.
Yeah, he was.
He's on it, he's on it, yeah.
Is he on, okay, I know, everything come out of his mouth is sustainable.
Yes, yes, he is, yeah, yep. Oh, yeah, I work closely with Ted, yeah.
Okay, well, I'm the result of them.
Okay.
Getting the garden, leave the garden before we get a grant for it.
Okay. Maybe go to the garden in the morning.
I don't know. This is just.
Oh, right, yeah.
Here, this Catherine, what?
Okay, thank you. Oh, okay, I'll reach out to her.
That's her card.
Yes, I have to do some updating on that.
Okay.
So basically, that is the whole, that's what we're working on. We're in the very early stages. But the most important thing is going to be getting this input and making sure it's really carefully analyzed and that the strategies that we want to implement are doable. Because if we have like these very theoretical ideas that we actually can't do, it's not going to make a difference. So that's why we really want to make sure we get enough feedback and then we come up with ideas to fix these things that are useful.
I have another question. Gary, would he have anything to do with, you know, the proposed health group clinic that we had with Green?
Oh, I heard about that. I heard about that. I'm not involved in it. Oh, okay.
Green was the greatest name.
Oh, yeah.
Remember? Yeah, the whole, I didn't know she was, you know.
Oh, okay.
She had some doctors and nurses, you know.
You know about Shereen Davenport?
That was out of Rutgers, no.
Oh, somebody did that?
Well, that's the problem there. That's the problem.
Yeah.
That was out of Rutgers.
The problem there.
Shereen.
Yeah, the whole hospital together and senior citizens though.
Yes.
She was going to get 935.
Yeah.
Supposed to come do that.
I heard about that recently, yeah.
Yeah, it would be great, but she had to go away to college and she's a doctor now.
Oh, yeah.
But that's the problem there.
Okay, all right.
And I don't know, you know.
Yeah.
We always, still hoping that that would happen.
Oh, that's great, yeah.
I want to ask you, because actually we're ceremony at the BOE, I don't know if any of you were, it was, I think it was actually literally yesterday.
Okay.
No, it wasn't yesterday, it was on Monday, never mind. But there, they were actually collecting feedback on the clinic plan, and I noticed something, which was, adults were talking to the clinic people just fine, but they were trying to get feedback from everyone, and a lot of the teenagers and students were just ignoring them. And that's something I've noticed a lot, like a lot of young people here in the township just don't have a lot of faith in the government. They think it's ineffective, they think it's inefficient, they think it's incompetent, for lack of a better term. And honestly, that is a difficult discussion to get past when you're trying to get input from everyone in the community, so what are you gonna do to kind of work past that?
Well, I mean, we definitely wanna get feedback from the younger group, that's for sure. I mean, I am not really sure how to address that upfront, I mean, maybe if we have a.
We have Dr. O'Malley, he's on the committee, so the school system, you should work with him.
Yeah, so we have the school system involved. I don't know if that's gonna address the problem though, I mean, maybe having, I don't know if like having a more relaxed kind of focus group with the younger people is better, or kind of like doing it more, I don't know if doing it more digitally is better, I'm not sure what the best way to be is, but anything you can give me advice on would be great, you know?
And you know, also, the lady, at the new committee center, she's in contact with the people in the garden, and there's a young, two young guys there that are gonna be involved with the garden and so forth. So I forgot her name. But I'm gonna make sure that, you know, I'm gonna talk to her, seeing that, you know, you're still here, or you decide to talk to her. And let her know that she was probably, you had sustainable information and so forth. And then maybe between you guys, you can develop some sense of the younger people getting involved to the community garden, and they hope they will fight for stuff. And I forgot her name, man. She's been assigned to Kathy Safi, and the two young kids, the guys from high school, that works at the community center, that works at the new center, and getting involved with the whole health thing and the community garden. So to answer your question, is to get hold of them, maybe you guys can develop something where you can learn the whole process of getting the young kids more accessible to the garden.
Make the same presentation to the Board of Education. I can call a different presentation to the seniors and juniors and.
Right.
Mr. Pitt made a really good point. I think like we need to engage with student leadership.
Yeah.
A lot of the people who lead like clubs or groups, they have a lot of connections with other students.
Right.
And if they're kind of promoting it to people, it's a lot easier. Like I know if my friends are telling me something, I'm way more likely to listen than an adult who just walked up to me going.
Right.
Yeah, okay, yeah, I have a question about your affordable housing. Do you have any, are you preparing any reports for the township for the future? Could you give us any update on that?
So I'm not working on the affordable housing plan for the township, but, and I don't really have any update, I should say that, I really don't have any update on that. I couldn't get an update from Mark Healy, he's the one that's working on that, so I don't have an update.
Well, I'll tell you just one point, there is no, not one apartment in Franklin Township that lower income person can live in.
Yeah, especially.
Really?
Not one apartment, I'm gonna say it three times.
Right.
There's not one apartment in Franklin Township, the whole Franklin Township, that a person can afford.
No, you're.
And what, can I, not, this sounds like a dumb question maybe, but, so even the low and moderate income housing, you're saying is not affordable?
They're not affordable, none of, nowhere in Franklin Township.
The average cost of living is so high that even the lower bound is really difficult to afford.
And we really need, like, those even low income apartments, but they have done away with that, so we all have to suffer. And let me say this to you, this is really hurts me, from a high school student, if a high school student graduates from Franklin Township High School and get a job, and wanna get married, they can't live in Franklin Township. There's nowhere
thousand more apartments right in the middle of the hood. They can't afford nothing in the hood in the first place, so they've got more luxury apartments in the middle of the hood. There's another whole thing that.
And there's no, and in, now, in those new apartments that were just built, there's no affordable housing in there?
None.
And, there's none, okay.
None.
Wow, okay.
All the way up down Hampton Street, in the middle of the hood, all you gotta go through the hood, I call it the hood, like, all the way down Hampton Street. There's about a thousand brand, but they're still building them. They build them in the middle of the hood.
And that impacts the whole community.
Right, absolutely, yeah.
Yeah, it's gentrification, that's what gentrification means.
What's my law that if a new project is going up, all that has to be approved?
No, you said the wrong word.
Franklin Township people have reached their affordable, their.
Have reached their peak?
Yeah, have reached their peak for affordable housing.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
And I'm waiting.
They've been at their peak.
Right.
Close, the waiting list is closed for the last 3 years.
Yeah.
I'm not a person trying to, you know, get waitlisted for the home.
That means the person has to leave the township, and I think, some people think that's what they wanna do.
And there's a waitlist for.
Oh, you can't get it, yeah, those places, the senior department, yeah.
Johnny, we talked about that, right?
Right, exactly.
Oh, there's a waitlist for the senior housing, there's a waitlist for the senior housing.
I'm just trying to tell her that easy.
Yeah.
Maybe she'll figure it out.
Yeah, see, that is good information for us to know, because when affordable housing is set aside, the price of it is established by, you know, formula used in that affordable housing plan, but you're saying that is still too, it's still not affordable.
The kids, the family is still.
Can't come home to live. It's the same, you can't come home to live.
On the, Somerset County Office on Aging part of the community, right?
Yeah. But still, yeah, that's important to know, that is.
Very important.
So do you think most senior citizens stay in their house, like, or if they, say you have a house that you live in, and you wanna move maybe to like a more like senior friendly apartment or something that suits your needs better, you can't.
You can't, ladies, no, you can't.
So then people are staying in their home, which maybe they're not.
Well, they have to, because they can't go nowhere else.
Right.
Well, I had a house, but, now I'm in a 55 year old community.
Right.
But my rent is cheap, so.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, and now, once the senior citizens leave and tenants in the apartment, they gonna have to get a job nowadays to even sustain themselves. And then once they get a job, the rent, that low rent goes through the roof then, then it gets to be.
Oh, because they don't qualify anymore.
No, they have to put a low income, so.
Huh.
I mean, we have to come to a close here, so, if you have more questions.
No problem.
Any questions?
Well, maybe what I can do then, what I would like to do if possible, maybe at one of your next meetings, maybe I can come and do, like, we can actually talk about the questions on the survey and do a focus group, I think that would be okay. And then we can go through it, I'm gonna leave the survey with you guys, but the focus group questions, I guess, are a little, I mean, they're along the same line, but maybe I can come back to one of your meetings and we can just go through everything, if I can get that info, that would be great.
This is Darren Rose, it's always our fault, he's our leader.
I have a really good question, but I do have a request. This is my last meeting, so, I will be here. But, we do work with Haylen, and try to kind of get in contact with student leaders at the high school.
Yeah.
Because that is the best way to kind of get in contact with the youth, and they really do have very specific opinions about the township. A lot of people have thoughts that they don't talk about, because they just feel like there's no point. So if you can start making them feel like there's a reasoning behind what they're saying, they're going to start speaking out.
What's the reason you think that, like, have students in the past attempted to work with the township and have been kind of turned away, or is there, like, what's the reason for that?
I got some surveys of you guys, of all the things that the team high school would like to see happen, remember? I got some old surveys, so maybe I'll pull out some of them up.
Oh, yeah, that would be great.
And that also shares some light on some of the things you're talking about, you know, right?
And the interesting thing is, that those surveys, those policy prescriptions that everyone likes at the high school, most of them don't happen in the township. People don't see what they want happening, and so they give up.
So you guys were asked to fill out this survey, you filled it out, and there was no response to it or no action from it?
I mean, even in the government classes, we do surveys of our fellow students. Almost all of those surveys are like 90 to 10 against what the township does.
Really?
Yeah.
You
That's
okay.
But for example, a lot of students are really not very happy with the current principal at the high school, for example. Like, a lot of the decisions they've made regarding, even clubs, for example. Like, we now have clubs. Yeah,
Solomon.
Like, a few clubs applied for protest permits this year to, like, run protests during classes. They backtracked us and walked us in circles for months before we could do a single thing. And things like that make it really difficult for students to feel like activism has any point. Like when we're fighting the school administration just to get it done.
Right. Yeah. I can understand that completely.
Well, you mentioned something. Anything you have a problem with, comment. You know,
but
that
is
our base
effect.
I got
Nick.
Yeah, Max. Yeah.
Things that I'm interested in finding out. Systems were really outdated, first of all, and second of all, a lot of it was really complicated. Like, people who are younger just tend to have very short attention spans nowadays, so when it takes more than 5 minutes to register for a room, they just don't.
You're talking about a new community.
Yes.
The new community center, the parks, because it's all been put on that one app now, right? And that one app...
Now you have two brand new guys, both and they both just rented 439 to the military. Okay. Now that, I want you to understand, that center was built, the ground was built on a community action agency, like a black collar, you know, state agency. And on the ground, it's like sacred ground to me, but that's where I come from. Okay. Now they brand new there. I have been giving them some information to try to make them feel, you know, by the way, it's built in the middle of the hood. Okay?
Okay.
So I've been trying to give them some information, trying to get the people in the surrounding area, and but they're now adapting themselves, you know, from Little Bush to the hood. So it's kind of gonna take a little while for them to kind of acclimate themselves to the feeling of servicing the community in which everything that people ask for would be easier. And a lot of them rooms that they have down there, they're forgetting that it's in the hood. They have other things with the rooms, you know, they're forgetting where they're at, you know. But it's going to be a while before they get to where they can understand what you're talking about and what you're talking about. And I can tell you, I'm working on it. You know what I mean? But it's brand new.
Make it very, like, I don't know how to say it, like, inconvenient.
Buzzy, you know what Buzzy means?
Hmm?
You know what Buzzy means?
No.
Bougie?
Yeah, bougie? Bougie? Oh, bougie, sorry. Yeah.
I said it wrong, but I've been...
Oh, that's okay.
Bougie.
Yeah, you know what that means?
Yeah.
And that's what a lot of the people there are. Mm-hmm. You know, so...
Okay.
Once you understand that, you need to understand.
Cut this off.
information.
Thank you.
I'll have you again. If you have a survey, you want to fill out.
Oh, yes, I'm gonna, I left it here.
And
do you want one?
Yeah, you can mail it back, or you can, if you have a scanner, you want to email it to me, if you want to see, this is my email up there.
And then.
Whatever works for you, you know, or just leave it to me or Gary, whatever.
Yeah.
What about Sappy's name up there?
Sappy and I are working on it together, yeah.
That's the community center.
Yeah, and then, since we're losing our high school partner, we're gonna depend on Colleen to contact the high school and whoever you have to contact, indicate what we spoke about, because it's important to her to go into the high school. To have a good enough to kind of go to education.
Thank you, Rose. Do you live in the area?
I live in Manville, right next door.
Where?
In Manville.
You're in Manville? You live in Manville?
Yep.
That's good. I'm glad you live in Manville.
Are you?
I'm in the state of the state.
I have to cut this one. Thank you.
Thank you.
Stephanie Black.
Yes, she is.
Okay.
That's a different version.
Thank you all. Thanks very much.
Thank you. Should I leave? Oh, you don't have to take these with me. No, I'll take them with other people. Thank you so much. Yes. No problem. Thank you. And if you want me to come back, just let me know.
Yeah.
And then I'll talk to you more about.
I do, yeah.
Dawn's going to help with police safety and walk on trail, which will be awesome.
Woman just got with her.
Yes, I will.
Right. Yes, thank you so much.
Okay, we have to continue our meeting because it's getting late and, we have minutes to approve for March 23rd. We have minutes to approve for March 23rd and April 27th, so I need a motion to approve those minutes.
I'm not going to let the minutes be approved.
Okay, that's March 23rd, April 27th. I'm happy to call on the police report. So
everybody, thank you so much for having me.
For those of you that don't know me, I'm Officer Dawn Flanders, and I'm a police officer in Franklin Township. And I used to sit on the committee, but I now just show up sometimes. So my role in the township is I teach prevention programs in all the schools in Franklin Township. For the last 14 years, I taught the GRADE program, which stands for Gang Resistance Education and Training. And starting in September, we're switching programs to a program called LEAD, which is Law Enforcement Against Drugs and Violence. And I'm also assigned to the Community Relations Bureau. So I have a pretty big report for you tonight. So starting next week, we are going to start our bike patrol. So the bike patrol, which I'm a member of, will be going to different neighborhoods in the community, and we'll be riding our bikes around to, you know, say hello to everybody and be an extra presence in the community. So please step out and say hi to us when we're riding by.
Sure.
We are going to do biking with a cop on Monday nights, so that's going to be something that we're going to do that's for high school age students. So we'll be getting out in different areas in the community and biking actually with the community on Monday nights. We're also going to be starting new programs for our tradesmen classes and our cooking with cops. So these are programs that we have available through community policing. And they're going to be starting after July 4th. And all of these programs, you can look to our website for the Franklin Township Police Department under Community Relations Bureau. That's where you find all of our programs that we have to offer. By the way, which are all free programs that we offer. We do have the Youth Academy coming up from July 14th to the 22nd. This is for 8th to 12th grade and recently graduating seniors. This has been a very successful program. I've been with it since the beginning. We did extend it to a week and a half this year. We are having it at SGS again this year. We do have 20 recruits, and we do have room for a couple extras, so we did order a couple extra t-shirts and uniforms if we get a couple of late applicants. We are going to have the Division of Motor Vehicles come into our Community Relations building on July 28th between 10 o'clock and 2 p.m. If you need any DMV services. So you can go on to the Facebook for the police department. And you can look for the sign-ups for that, because there are going to be appointments the first week of July.
First week of July, anything?
So the first week of July is when they're going to have the Facebook sign-up on the police department for the July 28th. DMV will be at 935 Hamilton.
July 28th?
Yes, between 10 and 2. Yeah, we're still gonna have more stuff. Are you good or do you need more help?
No, I'm good.
Okay, perfect. All right, so we're gonna have our national night out. This is a national program all over the country. We're finally gonna have one on Tuesday, August 2nd. Is the date when everybody has it all over the country?
August 2nd.
From 6 to 9 p.m. This is going to be in the municipal parking lot. We have a lot of things going on. We have a country band.
You're going to have it in the parking lot?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Usually
what they do is they have, well, usually they have certain parts around the township that everybody does a little cookout in the area, and they come around that same thing. But the first time they do yours, we will do all yours in the parking lot. So we want people, they want people to come there.
Because there's a lot of free activities that we're going to have. We're going to have food trucks. There's going to be like carnival games and prizes. There's going to be a country band called Due South at the gazebo. And there's going to be a lot of activities for families in the communities.
We're talking about being a big
in the lot. I'm not really sure, to be honest. I don't know the answer to that question. But we are going to be looking for volunteers, so if anybody wants to volunteer, you can reach out to me through email, or you can call Detective Sergeant Rebecca Lee, who's in charge of my unit. August 2nd, 6 to 9 p.m.
I mean, what did it happen today? 20 years.
There's actually a website for National Night Out as well, so if you just Google National Night Out, there's a lot of information on there, just general information about National Night Out. Do I know them?
Yeah. You should reach out to them for the National Night Out.
Okay.
Anything else for the police report?
Yeah, we also still have the basketball program and the Critical Fit going on at the youth center. So there's always sign-ups for that. So all of our programs are free. And like I said, they're on our Community Relations Bureau section on the Franklin Township Police Department website. Out to all the parents who are coming in and showing up for the activities.
Okay.
So that way we are trying our best to get it out that way.
Right. I talk about it too. I mean, we use it when they have food programs and so forth.
Yeah.
They don't know when they come in, so there's been scabbards on them. I mean, today the code. There is no person that informs the community about anything.
Okay. So.
Just remember that,
No problem. I got it. And maybe we can get them when we're on the bikes, get it out that way. So.
Even that. Uh-huh.
Yeah,
great.
No problem.
That would be great. You see them? Yeah. Hey, boy, here. Hey, good here.
Any other questions?
And does the boy need to know?
Any other questions?
What's going on?
I'm sorry, I don't have any updates. But if there was any updates, then it might be posted on the Somerset County Prosecutor's Office website if you look under media. So
it might still be under investigation, I don't know.
Yeah, so usually if that information is released, it'll be sometimes if that's, you know, the Somerset County Prosecutor's Office will take it over, and then they'll do all their news releases on their website. So
yeah.
It's scpo.net.
Any other questions?
PO.net. And then you can also, again, you can look at our Facebook page. You do not have to be a member. So you can just sign on to our Facebook page and look for any updates there. But usually if it's like a bigger case like that, then it will be, all the media will come out through the prosecutor's office.
Any other questions? Thank you very much, Dylan.
All right, thank you, everyone. It was
thank
great
you
to
so
see
much.
Everybody.
Good
to
and
see you.
Yeah, I'll see you out there when I'm on the bike.
Okay.
Okay.
You
okay.
Should have to be in the night out. They should probably be able to provide you all the material.
No, that's great. I'll definitely do that. I appreciate it.
Okay, let me continue because we have to. So as I said before, this is our last meeting for Harry and Shaw. Who is an excellent senior commissioner like we all are. I believe you're going to Penn State.
No, I'm going to William
and Mary. So I wish you all the luck in the world and continue to be very successful. If you know anyone that wants to do a guidance counselor, I prefer a junior because Aline's going to be graduating, so next year we got the same problem again. So, we also have an opening for a commissioner because, as you know, unfortunately, as we announced last month, we lost Tom Vigancy, and so I have an. If you know anyone, please have him send me your resume. And have them go to the township with that form that they can fill out, and then we'll talk to him or her, and we'll appoint another commissioner. As we said before, even though Mr. Tibbs has some questions, the youth center opened up. We all went to the grand opening. I think they were there too. It took long in coming, and I'm sure in time it'll be worthwhile.
It'll serve the community.
It'll serve
like
it. It's the old SCAP building, and they really did a good job with it, I think. You know, so.
Oh, yeah, it was a new building.
Beautiful. Take advantage of this great summer camp at Colonial Park. Only $10 a day. Transportation, breakfast, lunch, and food. They even offer before and after care options. So we should advertise this. And you know, it is a new situation for the township. I believe Alex is handling it through the Interfaith Council. You also received an email.
Yeah, it's
okay.
Send back to Alex and say, where do you get the money? You know.
Oh, I have one.
Go ahead.
Very, very now. He went somewhere else. He was the main person I was coming here hoping to see, because he told me he's responsible for providing a work training.
Who is this?
Ron.
Councilman Ron.
Ron, yeah.
Councilman.
He's not here.
He's not here, but I want you guys to understand that is a major, major, major concern of mine. Because now he's gone, he's gone on a trip somewhere, and I was hoping he did something before now, and he's had it got it going on. Because guys, the police department is the finest police department in the world, Franklin Township. I want you to know that. And they know I know that, and I want to keep it that way. But I'll have to have that work training center, because we have the young men in this area have nowhere to go whatsoever if they don't have no job. And I don't want nobody getting hurt or getting shot. I'm working on that. I'm serious about that. So I need Ron to come in, you know, because the other guys are not doing anything. There's nobody else in town providing any type of services. Staff is on the list of the daycare center now, so there's no other person getting grants or community service in the community in the black community. No one, nobody.
Johnny, you were talking about this for a long time. I know.
Yes, sir. And I have to continue.
But you also have to have the council meeting under
well, you know where that's at, don't you?
Well, but still, I'm just saying.
No, I'm gonna keep on getting through the community, and HRC has always been a person that supported the issues going on in the black community. So I'm actually a person.
It's important to hear.
And I also, there's a member of the Human Rights Commission said he's going to provide that. That's why I just want to let you know.
We all being reporters.
I know.
So they hear
you. I hope they hear me, but they've been hearing me for years. So.
Anything else?
Mr. Pierce, I thought the pool over here.
Yeah,
what's going on?
I talked to a lady yesterday. They had a group over there yesterday that had, they're doing lifeguard training now. They're supposed to start next week, I think, for those schools.
Okay, great.
They're doing lifeguard training now. I'm going to see them yesterday. It was all set down the board.
Keep us posted on that.
So what's the registration in everything for?
He hasn't seen anything. That's the major thing now. The community center, they don't do the same thing. They post things on the computer and other stuff. And they got kids around the area that don't know nothing about the pool you've been over.
Well, speak to Bob about that.
Yes, I'm going to do it again. I've been talking to him before about that. I got all the information about you. But yes, I'm on it.
That's a good question.
Absolutely.
Because we always
thought about the pool. You remember the whole thing about the pool? Now we got a new group now that's taking over. I've talked to him before. I haven't seen him before.
Because we always have you handle that stuff.
Yes, sir.
Okay, very good.
I'll keep you abreast of the team, sir. Thank you.
Anything else? If not, when's high school graduation? Friday this week at 6 o'clock?
Congratulations.
We wish you all the luck in the world.
We come back to visit us sometime.
I promise I will.
I know you will, though.
I'll take a motion to our next meeting is July 27th. We have as our tentative guest the new